Hey, I'm Jake, and today's topic on the steaming pile has my dick harder than calculus because we're going to be talking about cartoons, comic characters, video games, and horror because we're talking about Jeffrey Combs. Let's start with horror. Most fans of the horror film genre are aware of Jeffrey Combs. He's known for a lot of horror films, especially adaptations of Lovecraft stories. Granted, they're not the most faithful things in the world, but they're fucking entertaining, so who cares? So first up, we have the Re-animator films, starring Jeffrey Combs as Dr. Herbert West. In the first film, Combs, as West, is expelled from a university overseas and attends the Miskatonic University, a fixture in a lot of Lovecraft stories. Most of the movie takes place in Arkham, Massachusetts, and inside the Miskatonic University. The story centers around Herbert West's experiments with his reagent and bringing the dead back to life. In the second film, Bride of the Re-animator, Herbert West discovers that he can reanimate body parts independently of the whole body. This means limbs and the like. Now, the third film, Beyond Re-animator, I'm only bringing up for the zombie dick versus zombie rat fight, which we'll show you now. Next, let's talk about From Beyond, starring Jeffrey Combs as Dr. Crawford Trillingast, a movie that centers around a machine that allows the user to peer beyond the veil. But once the machine is active, or resonator, the life forms that can be perceived can also perceive the user and interact with the user. This is a great movie. I highly suggest that any of the movies I'm about to mention and have already mentioned, you go see. Except for maybe Beyond Re-animator, but watch that just for, again, the penis rat fight. Anyway, if anyone remembers this sound, you've obviously seen Castle Freak, which is another great Jeffrey Combs movie where he stars as the protagonist John Riley in a sort of redemption arc where he has to confront his past and battle the Castle Freak. Jonathan Fuller is probably the MVP of this film. Love Jeffrey Combs, but this is a pretty subdued, although great performance by Jeffrey Combs, but Jonathan Fuller is definitely the star of this film as the Castle Freak or Giorgio. Highly recommend you watch this Stuart Gordon classic. Now, not only is Jeffrey Combs known for starring in horror films and especially the adaptations, as we've already mentioned, of Lovecraft's work, he's also starred as Lovecraft in 1993's Necronomicon, Book of the Dead, or Necronomicon, Beyond Hell and Back, depending on which copy of the DVD you have. This is an anthology film where the connective narrative is Lovecraft researching the Necronomicon at a monastery or library, and while reading the books, three other narratives unfold, all connected by the initial Lovecraft research. I mean, we've seen anthology films do this before where the narrator recounts something happens in the narrator's story, next story, back to narrator, next story, and so on and so forth. This is a pretty good one. Not only has Jeffrey Combs played H.P. Lovecraft, quite possibly the greatest horror author of all time, but he's also played Edgar Allan Poe in the Masters of Horror series, The Black Cat, which centers around Edgar Allan Poe sort of living out the events of the story, The Black Cat, which then in turn inspires him to write the story of The Black Cat. Now this gives Jeffrey Combs the distinction, I believe, of possibly being the only actor to have played these titans of horror, Edgar Allan Poe being maybe the most well-known author of horror stories. In fact, H.P. Lovecraft very much admired Edgar Allan Poe's work and thought that his work was vastly inferior to Poe's. Now, I think I'm a way bigger fan of Lovecraft's work. I mean, hell, Lovecraft gave us Cthulhu, Dagon, Yug-Sothoth, Nyarlathotep, Azathoth, and so on and so forth, and not even just his cosmic horror. Lovecraft's stuff is great. Some other notable horror movie roles of Jeffrey Combs include, but are not limited to, his role as Dr. Vanicut in the remake of A House on Haunted Hill. The movie differs quite a bit from the original Vincent Price flick, as the supernatural nonsense that's going on is not put on by the Vincent Price character in this movie, played by Jeffrey Rush, but is actually supernatural phenomenon. Combs plays the aforementioned doctor and the ghost of the aforementioned doctor. Next up, we also have to mention The Frighteners, starring Michael J. Fox, with a standout performance by Jeffrey Combs as Milton Dammers. And lastly, as far as his horror movies are concerned, again, not scratching the surface, this guy is prolific. Look at his IMDb, it's insane. But let's mention The Attic Expeditions. I'm not really going to talk about The Attic Expeditions much, but I do have to say, along with Combs' performance as Dr. Eck, man, dude loves to play some doctors, it also features a pretty great cameo by Alice Cooper as a mental patient.
Yes, he's expecting your call. Hold, please.
I am a wet nurse, not a bellhop. I believe this is your patient.
Mr. Leventhal, what are you
Fine, doing? I admit it. I was trying to escape, but it's because I saw the taxi. I mean, I would have tried to escape even if I didn't
Security
see the taxi.
Security to the front desk. Two code sevens.
Oh, no. No. You see, I'm not a patient here. I'm a doctor. I'm here on business. It's the medication. They make me take it. I think they have the wrong dosage, but they won't let me see a doctor. I feel fine. I feel wonderful. Except for one thing, I'm shrinking.
Subdue them both.
No. I'm a doctor. I believe you're expecting me.
Of course you are, doctor. And we're expecting you to cooperate.
Measure me! Measure me!
Gentlemen. And I think it also maybe has the only time that Jeffrey Combs shared the screen with the Teddest of Raimis.
It is a pleasure to finally meet you, sir. Your work has been an inspiration to me.
Yes, and I've read all of your published works. It's inevitable that we should work together. I'll tell you something. Your timing is perfect.
Who many of us may know from several other horror films, including The Man with the Screaming Brain, Evil Dead 2, Army of Darkness, and Joxor from Xena and the Legendary Adventures of Hercules. Moving on, let's talk about Jeffrey Combs' roles in Deep Space Nine, or more specifically, one of his roles. He had a few recurring characters, but the one he's most noted for playing is Wei-Yun. Now, Wei-Yun was a recurring character, as Wei-Yun had multiple deaths, but Wei-Yun was a clone. And every time one of the clones would die, the next clone would be activated. In fact, Wei-Yun was once killed by the most metal Star Trek character, Worf. Now, maybe if Wei-Yun had been a barrel, he'd have stood a chance. Which gives me an idea. It's a good thing that Worf was never in the Super Smash Bros. Game, because Donkey Kong would wreck him. You Star Trek nerds know what I'm talking about. The rest of you, kick rocks. In addition to Combs' varied movie and TV roles, he's also provided a lot of voices for video games and cartoons, some of which we will now briefly mention. If you were a fan of the more recent TMNT, or Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles CG series on Nickelodeon, not the current Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles series that's airing, but the previous one, then you probably remember the Rat King. This interpretation was quite a bit different than the original comics or the late 80s, early 90s cartoon run, although it was great, extremely creepy, and really fit Jeffrey Combs' acting style. And normally, I'm not a fan of deviations from the comics, but I liked this. And if you're a fan of Jeffrey Combs or the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, give those episodes a shot. In addition to this, Jeffrey Combs has also provided the voice for Ratchet in several of the more recent Transformers cartoon series. Also, do you remember Earth's Mightiest Heroes, the short-lived Avengers cartoon that only lasted 2 seasons, sadly? Hey, in my opinion, that was the best Marvel episodic cartoon series that appeared on a major network since X-Men the Animated Series from the 90s. Real good. Loved it. Now, two of the most standout episodes, in my opinion, were the two episodes in which Mr. Combs voiced Samuel Stearns, or The Leader, the hyper-intelligent villain from the Hulk comics. This was a two-part series called Gamma World, in which the world was irradiated and people were turned into Hulk-like monsters and the Avengers had to stop them. A real fun two-parter with a lot of standout moments. If you're a fan of the Avengers comics, you'll probably dig this whole series. I suggest buying those DVDs if you're a fan of the comics. Just excellent, excellent series, and I did not much care for the successor series to it. Whatever Avengers cartoon started to air afterward, granted it had superior animation, but it did not have the same comic book feel. Now, we talked about a Marvel voice, but Jeffrey Combs has done a ton of DC comic book character voices in video games and cartoons. We'll briefly discuss one of the video games, Injustice 2. In Injustice 2, Combs was the final boss, Brainiac, providing the voice for all of the character interactions, the fighting, and the cinematics told a pretty compelling story, only enhanced by Combs' extraordinary voice acting. Many of you may not like story modes in fighting games, but this one is definitely worth a play. Now let's move on to a zanier appearance in a DC Comics-related property by Combs. If you remember Batman Brave and the Bold, which was a very campy, sort of Silver Age-based cartoon, which kind of had nods not only to the Silver Age, but maybe to the Adam West era of Batman. Jeffrey Combs appeared in one episode as Kite Man. Pretty fun scene, pretty fun flashback. Combs just really sells this. It's serious, yet ridiculous all at the same time. It's a fun little role. Now we come to sort of the merger of the Batman and Superman animated series, the new animated adventures of Batman and Superman. These were usually about 20 to 30 minute episodes featuring either the Caped Crusader or the Man of Steel. The art was sort of updated from this time period from the original series. And sometimes the art was a little bit better, sometimes it was a little bit worse. I didn't really care for the new interpretation of Poison Ivy or how the Joker was drawn as much, but the Scarecrow's look I felt was vastly improved. He went from sort of a dime store looking Halloween costume. Well, honestly, he had several iterations throughout Batman the Animated Series. The look changed constantly, but to me the best was the series we're talking about. He was taller, gray, had sort of a Quaker, you know, the oatmeal guy sort of hat, a noose around his neck, and looked more kind of like a zombie in appearance. Carried around a scythe, if I remember correctly. But not only that, the original voice actor had been replaced in this updated version with Jeffrey Combs, who in my opinion was a much better Scarecrow. Not a knock on the original voice actor who had played the character in previous seasons, but a vast improvement in my opinion. And finally, we move on to Justice League Unlimited, where Jeffrey Combs played, in my opinion, the most compelling and fun part of that entire series with his interpretation as the Question. Now, although the Question was a lot different in Justice League Unlimited than he's appeared in any of his interpretations in comics for the most part, he was still fun, interesting, and kind of crazy. He sort of seemed like a more paranoid Batman. Think if the Question were like a crazier, more paranoid version of Batman, crossed with Alex Jones, but instead of being obsessed with gay frogs, he was obsessed with aglets, the plastic tubes on the end of shoelaces and their nefarious purposes.
This doesn't have to continue. I can stop you from seeing the visions at any time. You stole files from our computer. Just tell me what you've learned.
Topically applied fluoride doesn't prevent tooth decay. It does render teeth detectable by spy satellite.
Tell me what you know.
The plastic tips at the ends of shoelaces are called aglets. Their true purpose is sinister.
Tell me what you know.
There was a magic bullet. It was forged by Illuminati mystics to prevent us from learning the truth.
Have it your way. This will continue until I break you. Perhaps even afterwards.
Now again, we've only scratched the surface of this amazing actor. Check out his IMDb for more roles. Find anything he's in. Because even if he's only in it for 5 seconds, it's going to be a glorious 5 seconds. My point is, we do not appreciate this man enough, and we should be ashamed of ourselves. Hollywood at large should be ashamed of itself. Maybe not just for that reason, but for that reason too. Well, that about wraps it up for this video. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. I'm Jake, and this was The Steaming Pile. Now add the fart.
That's going in the video.
Quite possibly. Yeah, it needs to. Then cut.